Hi everybody. This tutorial is about running Phenix Polder via the graphical user interface. A polder map is an omit map, which excludes bulk solvent around the omit area. This way, weak densities may become visible, which can be otherwise obscured by bulk solvent. Only two input files are required, a model file and a reflection file. Furthermore, the atoms to be omitted have to be defined. Here's an example where polder maps can be useful. The electron density map in green shows an omit map of a mass molecule in structure 1 ABA. The map is contoured at 3 sigma. At this level, only a few electron density peaks around the heavier atoms are visible, and several carbon atoms do not have electron density. The omit map seems therefore not very convincing for placing the mass molecule. However, the unclear density might be due to the bulk solvent mask, which is shown here as a violet mesh. In the omit map, the bulk solvent occupies the area of the mass molecule and can therefore obscure its density. Polder maps exclude the bulk solvent mask in the omit region and might help visualizing weak densities. In this tutorial, I will show how to calculate a polder omit map for the mass molecule. To do this, open the Phenix GUI. In the panel on the right-hand side, choose Maps. Scroll down to the last option, which is Polder Maps. Click and a new window opens. Here we choose the input parameters. For bookkeeping, start with choosing a job title, such as Phenix Tutorial. To compute a polder map, we need two input files, a model file and a reflection file. Click on Browse and choose your model file in the pop-up window. Then do the same for the reflection file. If there are several data labels in the reflection file, it might be necessary to choose the appropriate ones. In this example, there's only one possible label for map calculations. An important input is the omit selection. This defines the region for which the polder map is calculated. The mass molecule for which we want to calculate a polder map is in chain A and has residue number 88. In the Phenix selection syntax, this corresponds to the following string, which needs to be typed in the box next to omit selection. Chain A and RESEC 88. RESEC stands for residue. The resolution limits can be changed in these boxes. By default, Phenix Polder will use all available data from the reflection file. Below are some optional parameters. It is recommended to keep the default values. An exception is maybe the output prefix. It will add a string to the output file name, which is convenient for bookkeeping. Now we have all necessary input for running Phenix Polder. Click Run to start the program. The calculation should be rather quick. For a small protein like in this example, it should take just a few seconds. Let's first have a look at the output log file by going to Run Status. In the top part of the log file is a summary of the input parameters, followed by a summary of the omitted atoms. It is recommended to have a quick look at the summary to check if the selection is correct. Remember, we wanted to calculate a polder map for the mass molecule with residue number 88 in chain A. As you can see, the selection was done correctly. Below that is a list of crystallographic R factors for the unmodified input model and data, for the polder map, and for the conventional omit map. The values should be fairly similar. Towards the end, there's a list of map correlation coefficients. These help to judge if the density in the polder omit map resembles to a modeled feature or to bulk solvent. I recommend looking at CC13, that's this value here. It should be larger than CC12 and CC23. In our example, it is 0.79 versus 0.59 and 0.48. The density in the polder map therefore represents most likely the mass molecule. It is out of scope of this tutorial to explain how the correlation coefficients are calculated, but if you want to know more about them, please read the paper about polder maps. If Qt is available on your system, the polder map can be opened from the Phenix GUI by going to the Results tab. Click on the empty Z file and then click Open in Qt. Let's center on the mass molecule. By default, Qt will load two maps. The first one is the polder map. The second one is the conventional omit map. Here's the polder map. It shows electron density for almost every atom of the mass molecule. So it is very convincing that this molecule is present in the structure. Let's compare this to the conventional omit map, which we saw in the beginning. Here we have only a few electron density peaks covering some atoms of the mass molecule. So this shows the usefulness of the Polder map compared to the conventional omit map. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, contact us at help@phoenix-online.org or tutorials@phoenix-online.org.